Hey everyone, Cristy Lee here with a very special edition of Driveline Forensics. Today we're working on a tractor that is shimmying and wobbling when it goes over 65, which is not good. So we're gonna take out the driveline causing the problems and replace them with the Spicer S175 single drive axle and the SPL350 Lite driveshaft. And that, my friends, will not only address those issues, it'll amp up the efficiency. We've got a lot of ground to cover, so let's get right to it. The tools you need for the job are straps, jack stands, a drip pan, tire dollies, an impact gun with metric and Allen sockets, seal pullers, hand wrenches, and maybe you'll need a new airline and some fittings. It depends on what's going on under there. To prep the vehicle, Marty and I put it where we'd have a good amount of space to pull everything out. Then we disconnected the battery, set the brakes, chocked the wheels, dropped the suspension, lifted the truck, and put weight-rated jack stands under the frame. Did I get it all, Marty?
Sure did. Let's get this drive axle out.
All right, let's do it. So if you were taking out the axle and drive shaft with the intent of putting them back in, you would want to mark all of the connections so you could put everything back in the same way it came out. But since we're putting in all new parts, we're gonna skip that step and start by taking off the lug nuts and pulling the tires. Then we'll drain the oil from the axle housing. Pull the axle shaft nuts from the hubs and fully remove the axle shafts. Now we're gonna release the park brakes to cage the air chambers. Take off the calipers, remove the spindle nut that holds the hub, and take the hub off the axle. I'm gonna make a note of the clocking of the torque backing plate so the orientation is correct when we put everything back in. Once that's done, I can unbolt and remove the torque plates from the axle flange. Then unbolt and drop the prop shaft from the drive head. Now, before we do anything else, let's secure this axle with some lifting straps. Now we'll remove the shock hardware, unbolt the upper torque rod, remove the U-bolts, and lower the axle housing to the floor and remove it from under the vehicle. All that's left to do now is finish getting the driveshaft out. First, noose the drive line with the safety strap. Unbolt the carrier bearing and mounting hardware at the rear of the transmission, then lower it down and carry it away with literally the best assistant ever. Thanks, Marty.
Anytime, Cristy.
I'm gonna talk to Jamie Hagen. Jamie's the guy whose truck we were just working on. And he's the guy who actually drives this truck. He's also a fanatic about performance and efficiency tracking for his fleet. So Jamie, what was going on with this truck that makes you wanna make a change?
Well, I noticed there was a little bit of a wobble or a shimmy in the cab once I got over 65 miles an hour. So I talked to a buddy about it, and he was bringing up the fact that he's a huge fan of Dana products. And his Mack Anthem had all of that in it, and I took it for a ride. Once I got over 80 miles an hour, it was still smooth as butter going down the road. So I thought maybe it was time to make a change.
Well, we really appreciate that, Jamie. And thanks so much for taking the time to talk to us and, of course, letting us work on your rig. We're going to make it great for you.
Thank you, Cristy, and you're welcome.
Let's put the new Spicer drive axle and drive shaft in the truck and get Jamie back on the road. Besides the tools we use to take everything out, you'll also need a seal jack, seal driver, lube, a dead blow hammer, and a ratchet set. Ready? The vehicle is still in the same position from when we removed the drive axle and the drive shaft. We chocked the wheels, dropped the suspension, lifted it, and put weight-rated jack stands under the frame. We also disconnected the battery. Now we'll put everything back in the way we took it out. First, remove seals from the hubs with the seal jack. Be careful not to damage the sealing surfaces. Then clean and lube all the seal areas in the hub and drive the new seal with your seal driver. Don't damage these seals either. Do that on both sides. Now we're gonna maneuver the new axle assembly under the vehicle and secure the lifting straps. When that's secure, set all tilt wedges on the housing and start lifting it into place against the spring surface. Now hang the U-bolt and snug down the nuts. You already know what I'm gonna say here, but I'm gonna say it again. Never reuse the old U-bolts. They're not that expensive, so just put new ones in. Now, put the stands back under the axle, reinstall the torque plates, and torque to spec. While you're here, reinstall the shocks. Next, We're gonna lube the spindle and hang those hubs back up by running the spindle nuts down while spinning the hub. That'll help properly seat the bearings. Depending on the style of the spindle nut, tightening sequences and torques vary, so make sure you see the manufacturer's specs. Now you're probably saying, Cristy, you know what part you're installing, so why aren't you giving us the torque specs? Well, it's because even though we know I'm installing Spicer parts here, this video is probably going to be used for installation advice on other parts, and I would never want someone to misunderstand and torque to the wrong specs. There's just too much at stake if these bolts back out. So, you gotta do your homework and read the manufacturer's guidelines. Now hang the brake calipers and torque to spec. Hang the prop shaft to the axle companion. Install the axle shaft. Hang the tires, take away the stands, lower it down, and we're gonna fill the axle with our Spicer lubricant from BASF. Then reconnect the battery and take it for a test drive. So there you have it. We've put things back together the Dana way and it's looking great. Thanks for sticking with me and getting her done. Now we still need to check in with Jamie and see how things are going on the road. And here we are. Let's see if that shimmy and wobble vanished since we pulled out the other brand axle and drive shaft and replaced them with Dana products. Jamie, hey, how's it going, man?
Hey, doing great. How about yourself?
Good, doing good. Now, I see that you're in your Mack Anthem, but you're not driving, right?
No, I'm not. Not right now. I managed to stop for a minute and, you know, use my time wisely in talking to you.
Okay, good. Well, I'm glad you're playing it safe. but it's been about 6 months since we pulled the other stuff out of your Mack Anthem. Now that you're running with the Dana products, we are just dying to know how the new ride is.
It's been a great revelation the last 6 months, getting to use the product. It made a huge difference in the truck itself, just the vibration that I felt in the seat, the dash, the truck is so much smoother now. It's kind of freed it up, really. It's really kind of, you know, helped it roll down the road just so much easier.
So the feel of the truck, I mean, something we talked about a lot was the vibration, the buzz that you were feeling before with the other products, but now with the Dana products, how's the new feeling in your truck?
Yeah, that's been a big difference. As a person who sits in his truck all day long, you know, 12, 14 hour days, day after day, you know, you get kind of used to things, and then you took that away and it was kind of a huge revelation, like, wow, like I had gotten used to this vibration in my seat and the dash, you know what I mean? And you just, it's all gone. It's just an effortless roll down the highway and I just love it.
This isn't your only truck. You have more rigs in your fleet. You're going to be using the Dana products in them as well.
Yeah, I recently decided to switch over the entire fleet. I purchased 5 more Anthems that are coming here in the next couple of months, and we're all going to be exclusively Dana Spicer products, and it's going to be a great experience. I'm looking forward to just having that.
So you've got more Mack Anthems on the way. You're going to supply those with Dana products. That means you're going to need more drivers, but having the proper setup and having this more comfortable ride, that's really great for your drivers.
Yeah, I think so. It's one of the reasons why I went to it. I mean, not only the efficiency gain, but also just the more you can make a truck more comfortable, the more people are going to want to drive it, the longer they're going to want to drive it. And that makes all the difference in the world these days when it comes to hiring people, you know?
All right. Well, Jamie, I'm so glad that you're seeing, well, should I say feeling the difference that the Dana products make. I don't want to hold you up on your trip. But I really appreciate you taking the time to chat with us and kind of give us an update on your truck now. So hopefully we'll catch up again soon.
Will do. Appreciate it.
All right. Safe travels, my friend.